Let's meet the visiting team, Minnesota Timberwolves. At small forward, Nemanja Bjelica. At the other forward position, Taj Gibson. At point guard, Jeff Teague. At the other guard position, Andrew Wiggins. At center, Carl Towns. The head coach of the visiting team is Tom Thibodeau.
Welcome everyone to another exciting edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here, and I'm joined by Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines. They're just off a road trip, and the Wizards are looking to settle back here at home. Last time they met was in Minnesota, where they beat the Timberwolves.
And anytime you come off the bench, you know your role. And that night, it was about scoring.
Well, Greg, and I think it complements the starters when you can have such firepower coming off the bench.
And the starting lineup for the Timberwolves. Gibson is the four with Towns in the middle. Teague out there with Wiggins. And it's Bjelica in at the three. Now here's Beal. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Satoransky. Knocks down the step back J. Satoransky's got the scoreboard going with his first points of the night for the Wizards. T kicks to Bjelica. Back to T. And a wide open look here for Wiggins. And it's off from 3-point range. Pass to Satoransky. There is no shortage of athleticism in this one tonight. Clark, both these teams just incredibly athletic on both ends of the floor.
Yeah, I agree with you there, partner. I mean, they cover so much ground, and they cover it quickly because of the length and speed they have as teams. I mean, excellent length on both sides of the ball in this one, and they play to their strengths, and that's length and athleticism.
And last season, Greg, you heard a lot of names brought up for most improved player in the league. And Otto Porter was one of them.
I mean, and I think for Porter, the change came when he just felt more comfortable from deep in terms of shooting. He always had a solid mid-range game, but now he looks comfortable from deep and has become one of the bigger threats we have in the league.
Shooting two.
He misses the free throw. Well, Greg, for two straight seasons before this, the Wizards have had a starting five that all average double figures on the year. The engine of this offense, I think, is the backcourt, but they can all hurt you, don't you think?
No doubt about it, Kevin. Having a balanced offense like they do makes it tough for teams to prepare defensively. You can't just double or key in on Wall or Beal because they do a great job of facilitating. I think the bigger question moving forward is just going to be, what will the impact of that bench be? And ultimately, that's going to determine whether they can contend.
And that one's good. Wiggins
Hey, it's a simple game. Just take what the defense allows. Wiggins reads it, smooth with the mid-range stroke. Knock it down.
Morris, a screen, passes it to Satoransky. Inside. Here's Morris. Finds the open look, and it's on target. Morris has got his first points of the game. So for Washington, their last game, a loss to the Heat in Miami.
And they couldn't get stops when they needed to. The opposition just too comfortable shooting the basketball.
Well, you know what, Greg? When the defense is that lax, come on now. They honestly deserve to lose. Can't let a team get into that kind of a groove.
And so it looks like Washington will retain possession here. And taking a broader look here at the year-over-year scoring trend for Crawford.
And maybe it's shocking, maybe not too shocking, but the scoring trend over the last few years has been going down a bit. I'm sure it's something he's well aware of, and we'll see if that continues to be the case.
First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Nailed from three-point land.
And right out of the gates, they are locked and loaded. Three straight scores early.
Floats it up for Wiggins. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. Beal can't get it to go. Timberwolves trail by 6. Porter with the steal. Unloads from 13. Beal's shot is good. Beal's got 5.
Nice way to start the evening. His number's getting called, and for good reason.
Well, you know, Greg, they can count on him to get buckets. I mean, he's getting the ball because he's very efficient when he has
working the in-between area, the kind of look that can get you into a rhythm early.
Yeah, and I think all credit goes to that being just good offense. I mean, those are the kind of shots they want, and they got them.
And so it's Minnesota with it, following the bucket by the Wizards. Ilica, and that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague.
Terrific awareness from the savvy point guard. Jeff Teague is excellent at getting the ball to the open man.
From 12 feet out, he's off on that one. So Minnesota will take it the other way. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
Yeah, and fortunately for them, I thought the opponent's defense just never showed up.
Yeah, you know what? The waters were calm for most of the game. I mean, little resistance, felt like they could get any look they wanted at any time. Boy, strange that he bricked that one. I mean, no clue where the defense was, and tell you what, they got very lucky.
Satoransky gets the bucket.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Quality looks they're getting, and they're capitalizing on them, guys. They have to be happy with this start offensively.
And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting 2.
And you know, it's amazing when you look back at the Andrew Wiggins, Kevin Love trade. Safe to say now that I think both teams really got what they wanted out of it.
Minnesota shooting their initial free throws of the game right here. And that one misses. Well, Andrew Wiggins, the pride of Canadian basketball, he is shown to be a very durable player, Clark, in his short career. Rarely misses a game if he ever does, and plays a ton of minutes each night out.
Yeah, and Kevin, even as a rookie, Wiggins logged heavy minutes. He often played north of 40 minutes a game. But he's so important to this team because of his impact at both ends of the floor.
And still varying opinions out there of what Andrew Wiggins can and can't do. But one thing that's indisputable, he's an incredible scorer. Right? Whether half-court transition, he can flat out fill it up in a hurry. And when he squares up, his height makes him a tough assignment.
Yeah, and he knows how to utilize that size. He takes advantage of it. And that's why he's able to take his time on these shots, because he knows he has that extra height advantage.
Now here's Crawford. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Golden State. And the basket by Jones. And Wiggins, his young career just getting better and better at scoring, Greg, while increasing his workload.
Yeah, and very few scorers can do that, especially from that two-guard spot. Wiggins has that special talent where he can flat-out carry an offense. Scary to think that this is a kid who is just scratching the surface.
And Towns the bucket on the assist from Jones. Towns has got his second bucket of the night.
You see, Towns doesn't dip much after the catch. I mean, he gets the ball right up to the set point and ready to deliver. Really sound fundamentals in that regard.
And a high-scoring first quarter. Both teams really filling it up. It's the Wizards leading by just two. We'll get right back to the action when we return. Welcome back, folks. We have a close game here at the start of the second quarter of play. And what stands out to you from Washington in this one?
Well, already in the first period, they found ways to get this offense ramped up.
Yeah, nice beginning so far. This is how you play out of the gate.
The Timberwolves trail. Oubre out there with Mike Scott. Then it's Jody Meeks. Then there's Ian Mahimi. And it's Frazier in at the point. That's the group starting the second quarter for the Wizards. Wiggins has gone 1-3 from the field here. Meeks with it, and Crawford picks him up defensively. The Wizards working the ball around now. Outside, Scott, the dish to Meeks. Clock at six. Washington needs to get a shot off here. Oubre hands the shot from the wing. Oubre's got the opening basket here in the second quarter for the Wizards. You know, Clark, at the end of last season, the Timberwolves unveiled this new logo they're sporting this season. They felt it was time for an update, and you have to say it looks pretty sharp.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, most teams in the NBA want to mix their logo up every so often to keep it modern and up-to-date and fresh. The Wolves have a young group and felt it was the right time to re-examine the logo, and I can't argue with them. Sometimes a little change like that can pay big dividends.
The free throw drops for Towns. And a lot of scorers in the NBA just demand so much attention when they have the ball. Which players you think, Clark, in your eyes, gets the most attention from a defense?
Well, I mean, how about the MVP of last season, Russell Westbrook? I mean, you can't take your eyes off of him when you're watching the game and certainly when you're playing against him. And you've got to know where Steph Curry is at all times, whether he has the ball or not. He's that dangerous. And James Harden is one of those guys who's a magnet for attention as well. And you always can throw LeBron James in any conversation about most watched players or most focused on players.
A nice shot by Frazier.
Okay, you got a nice little back and forth going here.
Yeah, and I like it. I love seeing that. It's a lot of fun when that happens. These teams are going at each other from the outside.
Now, here's Wiggins. A 23-point game for him in the win against Golden State.
Man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Yeah, and as quick as players are at this level, in this day and age, I mean, you've got to be perfect in your anticipation to draw the charge.
And Washington making a change here. Beals checked in. Taj Gibson's checked in for the Timberwolves. Mialica comes in for Andrew Wiggins.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
And, Greg, it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
Now here's Jones. He has six. Here's Gibson. And two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot. And Washington called for the foul.
Taj Gibson is a solid role player, really one of the best we have. A good rebounder and defender with a soft touch from the mid-range and can score without having plays called for him.
Now let's take a moment to get your guys' take on the scoring so far for the Timberwolves.
Boy, the three-point shot has really been dropping for him early on.
And also another aspect of their game that's been super so far tonight is how they've been sharing the basketball.
No good on that one. and a new group getting ready for the Wizards. Gortat's checked in for Mahini. Markieff Morris comes in for Scott. Porter's checked in for Oubre. And Satoransky's subbed in for Tim Frazier. And the Timberwolves also making a change. Teague's checked in for Jones. Second free throw, no good.
You know, the last few seasons, the Timberwolves assembled a terrific young core. Now they're ready, I think, to take that next step forward, adding veterans like Butler, Teague, and Gibson. I think they're ready to win right now.
Now, here's Porter. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Heat in Miami.
How about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Here's Teague. Jang, a screen. Here's Bielitsa. He's coming off a 10-point game against Golden State.
And he also looked to attack at the defensive end of the floor. Three steals in that game.
Now here's Teague following the miss by Taj Gibson. Gibson with a screen on Porter. There's the pass to Bielitsa. There's Crawford with the three. Rebounded by the Wizards. For the Wolves in their breakout season, everyone was waiting for. The pressure is felt by the team. It's just hard to pick out when a group of young players, Clark, is going to put it all together.
Yeah, you're exactly right. But that Western Conference about as stacked as it's ever been, Kevin. But you know what? I think the Wolves are primed and ready to be contenders.
Here's Teague following the basket by Otto Porter. The Elite misses. Porter in the corner. A three-pointer, no good. Minnesota's gone 2-for-5 from three-point land since the end of the first. Teague dishes to Crawford. Back to Teague. Shoots. And once again off the mark by Minnesota.
That's what they want. A good look from the mid-range game. Hey, but unfortunately they came up empty.
Crawford against Beal. Crawford kicks to Bielitsa. Knocks down the three ball. Bielitsa's got 6 in the quarter. Several lead changes going on here in the early portion of this game.
It reminds me of that cameo song, Back and Forth.
Now here's Beal. He's got 5. Pass to Satoransky. And there's the call on Marcin Gortat. That'll be his second foul of the game. Some changes for Minnesota. Carl Anthony Towns checked in for Gorgui Dieng. And Andrew Wiggins is subbed in for Jamal Crawford. ...50 seconds left to play here in the half. Gortat against Towns. And it falls over the rim and in. And now it's a 3-point Minnesota lead.
Perfect touch from mid-range. I mean, the subtleties of Towns' game, part of what makes him unique, his size and his skill set, and also his maturity as a young player. Very impressive.
It's good. And it's 7 points for Otto Porter Jr.
And, you know, it's obvious he's a talented scorer. I mean, that's a given. A guy you can depend on to get it done in a lot of ways.
Teague, the pass to Bielitsa. Towns down low. Right through the D for the layup. Towns has got the lead up to 3 now for the Timberwolves.
Still in the process of shining his game up. Towns looking like a seasoned vet there.
And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of basketball. Timberwolves lead by 3. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin, with Carl Anthony Towns. Carl, you got some scoring going in that first half. What did you take advantage of?
I'm just finding spots, not chasing it, letting it come to me. Just using what my teammates give me.
Productive half so far, Carl Anthony. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, folks. Welcome back. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. This is the halftime show on 2K Sports. The first half was all about Carl Anthony Towns. He had 12 points, 3 rebounds, and 1 steal. He's in a crazy zone right now and seems to be even hotter than he was in their last game. And Kenny, what did you see out there from the Timberwolves?
Well, they were lighting it up from three, and that was the difference in the first half. They did a good job of running off screens, spotting up, and getting rid of the ball quickly. And their shot selection, solid.
And over to Shaq, your take on the Wizards.
Well, I'll tell you what I saw in the first half, Ernie. Three things. Soft defense, not enough pressure, but they can still win this game. They need to ramp it up. Was that two or three? Doesn't matter. You understand, Ernie.
That's it for now as the second half's just about ready to go.
Welcome back, folks. A lot to see in that shot from high above Washington, the Capitol, the Supreme Court, the Lincoln Memorial. That is one heck of a view. Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far. Carl Anthony Towns has been sensational.
His points production thus far, off the charts. It's only been two quarters, just a great effort for him for the entire half.
Yeah, and it doesn't matter where he is on the floor either, Greg. He's making it look very easy. He's looking to score the ball.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. Timberwolves leading by three. So on the floor for Minnesota. Gibson is the four with Towns in the middle. Wiggins is out there with Teague. And it's Bialica in at the three spot. Now here's Towns. Shot clock at five. Here's Wiggins. And he banks in the layup. Wiggins has got his team on the board first here in the second half for the Timberwolves. And Zadaransky kicks to Beal. Dishes to Porter. There's a screen by Gortat. The feed now to Morris. The jump shot from the baseline is right on target. Morris has got his second bucket of the game to go.
That's how you move the basketball. Awesome passing leading to the bucket.
Bialica with the bucket.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Everybody on the same page, completely in sync, tremendous communication and awareness.
And you gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of a grind-it-out game.
And you know, guys, early in his career, Jeff Teague was more of a scoring point guard. As his career has continued, he's gotten much better at surveying the court and creating opportunities for his teammates.
They're outside, gets the three-pointer to fall. Porter's got 10 points in the game.
Three for three, and that's always a good way to start the second half.
T kicks to Bialica, feeds to Towns. Timberwolves passing it around. Towns sets the pick for Wiggins. Layup off the pick. And Towns lays it in.
You see Towns setting the monster pick? As he's filled out, he's become a real hard guy to get around when he screens.
Shoots the three. That falls. Nice feed that time from Wiggins. Wiggins has got his third assist on the night. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. Stolen. Here's Bialica. 12 points for him. Gibson dishes to T. Kicks it to Wiggins. Towns a screen on Beal. Four on the clock. Offensive rebound. Gibson. Fouled in the act of shooting. A three-point play chance coming up.
And you just hate to give up those second-chance points.
Yeah, those are back crushers. I mean, they really crack your back when you give teams second shots like that.
The Timberwolves shot 2 of 5 from the free-throw line. Here's what Washington's going with right now. Mahimi's checked in for Gortat. Oubre comes in for Otto Porter Jr. And Tim Frazier subbed in for Satoransky. Timberwolves also changing it up.
Mind the lane.
Gorgie Dangs lane. Checked in for Towns.
One shot.
And it's Crawford in for Bialica. And Clark, when you think back to your career, what do you miss the most about playing in the National Basketball Association?
Well, you know, for me, Kevin, because my career was cut short due to injury, I missed the opportunity to see how good I could have been on a winning team, on a playoff team. Back in the early 80s, the Pacers were building towards that, and I never got a chance to be part of a playoff team. And the camaraderie you establish in going through the shared misery and joy of competing is something that's special and unique to sports, and you really don't find it in any other venue.
And with the Tide running against them, needs to talk it over with his guys.
You're exactly right. Halting the other team's run momentarily, let's see what he comes up with now, Greg.
And a quick look at how things have been since the All-Star break, checking out the three-point shot ratio for Washington.
And clearly they haven't been shy about launching it from long range. That's the way the league has been going, and they are certainly embracing that trend.
Right around 3 minutes into the second half. Frazier kicks to Beal. Now here's Oubre. Tight defense on him. Beal can't get it to go.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Teague, the pass to Jang. A three-pointer, Wiggins, and he's good on the three ball. Wiggins has got seven now in this quarter.
And the D has gotten a little bit laxed here defending the triple.
Morris outside. It's Beal on the wing, guarded by Crawford. Five to shoot. Beal's shot is good.
And that's what you give up when you don't fight over the screen.
Yeah, I agree with you wholeheartedly. I mean, not a lot of effort put forth on defense there. I mean, I think he's definitely got to play up on him more and off the screen in that situation.
He used that pick to perfection. Crawford's got the lead up to 14 now for Minnesota.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Clearly just an example of a different mindset between these teams.
Now here's Beal. He's got seven. And again, Jamal Crawford. Crawford's got his second basket of the night. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for the Timberwolves.
Boy, their hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end, very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
Yeah, and another thing, they've created a lot of turnovers, but they've also been able to convert when they've got down in transition.
Boy, the defense did an awesome job there, Kevin. Big time work. Really distracting them, throwing off the shot. That's how you do it on D.
And you can see the play calling this half. Another one from distance.
Well, they're dialed in, locked and loaded from outside the arc. It's all about the triple so far.
Mahinmi a screen. They need this. Oubre, good. Oubre's got five.
Boy, they've been terrific from beyond here in the second.
Exactly what the doctor ordered. Those three-point bombs will erase the deficit quickly if they can keep it up.
Wiggins kicks to Crawford. Jang a screen. Teague against Frazier. Chalk up two there. Teague's got his first 2 points.
And you know, these are the kind of shots, guys, that Teague makes consistently. If the defense is laying off of him, he'll make them pay.
Frazier kicks to Beal. In the corner, it's Morris. And again, Washington with the triple.
Very well executed pick to give him all kinds of space to get that one off.
And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves. Their lead at 15 going into the break. They have been sharp from beyond the arc, putting on a terrific three-point shooting display. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. Now let's hear what Coach Tom Thibodeau was reviewing with his team in the huddle.
Defensively, make sure we're all getting rebounded. No second shot. In transition, everyone talking. No open three.
And Tom Thibodeau wanting his team to pay particular attention to certain areas of their defense.
Yeah, taking care of the defensive boards, allowing no easy baskets, on the fast break. These are key elements in terms of you having success.
Welcome back as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Not exactly a nail biter here, but you never know. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. Taking a look at the Wizards. Shot is out there with Gortat. Then there's Oubre. Then it's Jody Meeks. And it's Zadaransky in at the point. Here's Scott following the bucket by the Timberwolves. Oubre kicks to Meeks. Scott dishes to Meeks. It's rebounded by Towns. Minnesota leading by 17. Out of bounds, Washington takes possession. Wizards making a switch here. Porter's checked in. Porter. 60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. There's a screen by Gortat. And the rejection by Towns. It's Bialica. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. Bialica's got 4 points in the quarter. And Zadaransky kicks to Meeks. He dishes it to Porter. Here's the screen. At the elbow, Gortat to the wing on the left. 5 on the clock. Outside, Porter buries it from 3-point range.
I think he's been a steady, reliable option so far, but it's not enough. They need him to take charge, be more assertive on the offensive end.
Crawford kicks to Towns. Back to Crawford. That shot off. Ice D from Porter. Meeks passes to Zadaransky. He feeds it to Porter. Here's Zadaransky. Scott with a screen on Jones. From deep. They get the rebound. Here's Gortat. They shoot again, and he sinks the layup.
Boy, and the wingspan of Gortat, Kevin, helps him big time on the glass. Great at using his height and length to corral rebounds.
Now here's Crawford. Out left to the wing. It's Bialica. Off target from outside. Wizards trail by 14. Here's Zadaransky. Gortat dishes to Meeks. Off target from the wing.
Man, right play, wrong result on that one. Generally, you knock those down.
Not much else you can do there. I mean, that's what you want. Too bad they weren't able to finish it off.
Washington calls timeout.
And, you know, Gorgui Dieng is a big man who can play both the 4 and the 5. He doesn't stand out on offense, understated there, but very valuable and solid and consistent. He's a rim protector and a space eater, but also a pretty effective rebounder, too.
Presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Karl Anthony Towns.
Yeah, and his percentage from the field tonight seems almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
He silenced this crowd with an unreal display. His ability to drown out the noise and the hostility of an opposing crowd is pretty special. Washington making some changes. Markieff Morris comes in for Mike Scott. And Bradley Beal subbed in for Jody Meeks. Timberwolves also changing it up. Taj Gibson's checked in for Jan. Andrew Wiggins comes in for Jamal Crawford. And it's Teague in for Tyus Jones. Porter outside. Good for another bucket. He's made half a dozen now. 6 for 8 on the night. And Jang, a solid challenger at the rim with his shot blocking. Yeah, Clark, he doesn't mind having a secondary role on a team as long as they are winning.
Yeah, you know what? He's really comfortable in his own skin and what his role is. He's got great awareness. of how to help his team. Never tries to do too much on the offensive end, and he's really good at playing with any other type of big guy that the Wolves put on the floor.
Yeah, getting theirs before the defense can set up.
Perfect execution. That's how you take advantage of a transition opportunity.
Here's Sadoransky. Here's Morris. And the rejection by Towns.
A tremendous shot blocker in college, Kevin. Towns has packed that part of his game and brought it with him to the next level.
In the corner, it's Wiggins. Over Beal. And the shot no good, a bit short. Wizards trail by 15.
And this is going to end in a lopsided victory. I love the tenacity and aggressiveness, as well as the ability to close. You really got to give it up here for the Timberwolves.
They really had it going, guys. Their offense propelled them.
In this case, it was the higher shooting percentage that made the difference and earned them the W.
And for the year now, they'll ramp up their win total to an even 40.
And there's no victory sweeter than beating someone who's last beaten you. Tonight, they'll even things up at one apiece in their three-game season series against Washington.
And, you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for Karl-Anthony Towns.
Boy, that was a terrific performance on offense. He was out of his mind. He scored in so many different ways tonight.
Taking two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. And a new group getting ready to come in for Washington. Mahimi's checked in for Gortat. Mike Scott comes in for Markieff Morris. Kelly Oubre's checked in for Porter. And it's Jody Meeks in for Beal. The Timberwolves also changing it up. Cole Aldrich, he's checked in for Towns. Brown comes in for Taj Gibson. And Tyus Jones subbed in for Jeff Teague.
Not nearly as productive a trip to the line as he'd have liked. They need all their free throws to go down at this point.
Jones kicks to Wiggins, sinks the three-pointer, and the Timberwolves lead by 15.
Yeah, with this lead, that's probably going to do it. Fans heading for the exits.
And, Greg, you know how hard it is to win on the road, but they seem to have this one firmly in control and have been very impressive today.
Mahimi's shot is good.
Clearly, he's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass.
Outside, Jones. So it's Minnesota winning this one easy. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Hey, Kevin, thank you. Andrew, an impressive win for you guys. How will you look back on tonight?
It feels great, you know, I think the whole team played great. You know, we shared the ball, we grabbed rebounds, we made big possessions, you know, so I think it was a great game.
Hey, Andrew, congrats again. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And that about wraps it up. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. So long.